so many joyous moments here. So that's brought me some great joy. Every day that I come in and out of my office, can you guys see this print?
Yep.
This is me meeting Robin Williams.
Oh, how cool.
Oh, wow.
And so every day I come in and out of my office, this is the face I see. So how can it not bring me joy? Honestly, it's awesome. So as I show you my workspace, as I said, I know how blessed I am. I have a very large workspace and I overlook all these great windows. And I've filled it with a lot of photographs that mean a lot to me. Sort of like Tyler, I'm just gonna kind of hopefully have good connection and show you a little bit around my office. The first thing that brings me joy, obviously, is my children. And this is my daughter's IMBD page. I don't know if you can see it well. This is my oldest daughter, and it brings me great joy to know her dreams are in progress. And this reminds me every day of her hard work. And she graduated from college in December, and we're very proud of her. Some of the other things that I fill my office with are pictures, and I've been very lucky as a Sage business partner. I've traveled on 8 different President's Circle award trips. And my favorite one by far was Hawaii. And it was in Kauai. I think you guys were there, Eddie and Alex, correct? And Mark.
Was it the first one?
No, it was not. I'd been to Cancun. I'd been to a couple different ones. But the one in Hawaii was, I think.
I was there, yeah.
Yeah, 2011. Yeah,
I was there with my missus.
Yeah. And your missus. And it was in Kauai. And this is my picture from my phone. And this is called Shipwreck Island. And why, what I did is I download some of my favorite photographs and put them on art.com and they put it on a canvas. But my husband jumped off of that. He has a fear of heights. And while we were there, he dove into that water, which is quite dangerous and was a dumb thing to do.
Susan, can you move your camera up just a little bit? Like it's, yeah, there you go. Perfect.
Yeah, that's better.
Awesome. So it's really deceiving what my iPhone looks like and what you guys are seeing. So I really do appreciate that because it'd be defunct if you're not seeing what I'm hoping you see.
We missed the picture of your daughter too. We saw the credits down below, but we didn't see the top. What's your daughter's name?
Emily.
Emily Padone. Awesome.
Can you see it now?
Now we can. Yep.
So I also have, I'm not a golfer like all you other guys that are kind of talking about golf. I am a tennis player. I have been playing competitive tennis for years. And I kind of have all my trophies in the office, kind of reminding me of my champion spirit. Danny will love this. I don't know if you guys can see this bobblehead. Can you see my Ditka bobblehead?
A little lower.
There you go. Well, there you go.
That's it.
So I was able to be at the 100th NFL game Monday night with Bears and the Packers. I'm from Illinois originally, and they gave out those bobbleheads. Just makes me laugh. The other thing to kind of show you is a fountain for all you salespeople listening. 10 years ago, when I was redesigning one of my offices for IMS, I had read how keeping a flowing fountain in your office on the north side brings flowing cash. Cash, cash, cash. So I'm not joking. This thing is proven time and time and time again. When I turn it on, I get a new lead. I swear to you. You guys can get a fountain at Michael's for like $9. Bring in that cash.
All right, everybody needs to go get one by tomorrow morning.
Fountains are going to be the new toilet paper.
Amazon just sold out of fountain.
Nobody's getting it by tomorrow morning, I guarantee you that. Nobody's moving their ass to get it.
Nope, it's...
I just bought them all, Alex.
They will deliver, I'm sure. And so as I move over, and I already showed one of my kids, I have 2 girls. I don't know if you guys... Can you guys see this print?
A little higher up.
A little higher.
There you go.
This is my youngest daughter. And why I keep this in my office is because she made the cover of the Tampa Bay Times for being the very first girl in the state of Florida accepted to the number one hockey boarding prep school in Northern America. And she had a lot of odds to get there. She had to really beat a lot of odds to get there.
Wow, where's the school? Awesome.
The school's in Minnesota. Cool. It's in Minnesota.
Minnesota, of course.
All right. Oh. I'm going to kind of move. I don't know what you guys can see, but this is my workspace, and I'm about to tell a story about this bird bath. Can you guys see it?
Yep.
So I sort of like centering myself to nature, and I'm so lucky that I have all these windows back here. I have a bird feeder and this bird bath, and I'm going to switch to my computer so I can kind of show you a story about it. It's kind of cool.
Anybody get that credit card number that was sitting there on the desk?
I already screenshotted it.
Of course you found it, Heather. She already bought it and took a picture.
That doesn't sound very PCI compliant.
No, not at all.
Jeff, I'll call you for processing on those waters.
Can you guys see it?
Yep.
Yes.
We can. Yeah, we're just getting a little echo.
Let me try this. All right. Now, still going to get echo.
Hang up your phone. You might have to mute your headset.
All right. So I just kind of want to show you. This is my mom's house.
Yeah, doing great.
This is in the Smoky Mountains. This is where my mother lived. And it's.
I know, but I got the blood work back from my doctor.
Hey, Randy, you're about to share the results of your blood work.
HIPAA.
Yeah, we don't want to do
HR
that.
Is not here.
Can everybody see the screen okay?
Yep.
Okay, so my mom lived in the Smoky Mountains, and I don't know if you guys remember, but in November 2017, the Smoky Mountains were on fire, and her house burnt down. It was pretty devastating. It was a year after she passed away, and my little brother was her caregiver during that time, and he decided to live there and kind of revamp it, but he didn't have the opportunity. I did drive up there to try to see what we could salvage of my parents. And I don't know if you can see over here to the far right, this stump was sticking out of all the rubble. And I realized it was my mom's bird bath. And I was like, okay, I'm going to have to drive this back to Florida. And it is the only thing that was intact. Even the stairs to her home were completely demolished. So that is what I did. I hauled that back. There was one other thing that was standing strong. This to the right was the month I saw my mom went right before she died. She had these bears that were standing completely strong. So my brother kept the bears and I kept the bird bath. And it took me a long time to get it out of my garage, clean the soot, and kind of put it in a place that I thought I could enjoy it during the day. So when I was acquired 18 months ago by Net at Work, I decided to put it right outside my office window. And I get things all day long while I'm talking to customers and talking to you team members. I get the most beautiful birds and they bring me so much joy. It's awesome. So I wanted to share that story in sort of the vein of Anne's slides, a little family story. And now I'm going to switch back to my horrid iPhone and see what my family's up to so you guys can all say hi. All right. Does everyone see okay?
Yep. Yeah.
Or you guys may wanna pin the new presentation.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Click that one and then you can pin it, right? Yeah, there it is.
Yeah, there we go.
Hi, Emily.
Hi.
Say hi to everyone.
Hi everyone. How are y'all?
This is my daughter, Emily.
Hi, Emily.
Hi, guys.
And this is one of our COVID projects we're working on, our Broadway puzzle. You New Yorkers are really love seeing that's what we're working on. As I walk through my house, let's see what my youngest daughter. Aw, and that's my fur baby. That's baby. Baby. Come on, no one can tell what you look like. Okay, she's getting old. This is my youngest daughter, Molly. She is displaced from Minnesota now. Hi, Molly. And she is displaced because she is a senior and they are obviously had to shut the school down. And as a boarding school, they didn't have an e-learning program and they had to quickly figure out how to do that. And she is managing to do that. Finally, the last but least. Oh, let's see what's happening in here. This is my husband. This awesome. Is our guitar room. I don't know if they can hear you, dear. You might have to crank it. You might have to crank it louder. I don't know. Can you hear it, Seth?
Yeah, AC/DC. I got it.
AC/DC.
Oh, they said AC/DC. Awesome sauce. And that's it. That's my family. That's what makes me happy. Thank you all for your time.
Wait, can we take a pause at the bar?
Yes.
Ralph will be there.
The bird story was awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Very
nice, Susan. Yeah.
Awesome family.
Thank you, Suzanne.
Thank you.